again, in Islam, we don't have just Muslim. We have Muhajir Ansar as well. You know this name, Muhajir Ansar?
Right.
Allah gave it to the Muhajir Ansar. Muhajir Ansar never existed. So not just Muslims.
Right.
Allah. So Salafi's name, because, for example, Prophet Muhammad, when he said, my ummah will be divided into 73 sects.
Right.
He said, all of them deserve to be punished with the fire, yes? Who are they? Did he say Muslims?
No,
he didn't say Muslims.
No.
Why? Because our argument is all of us are Muslims. Because Prophet Muhammad is a fasihul balighu al-mubinu. He's eloquent. And so he was to clarify because the other groups are Muslim too. And now if all of them are Muslim and he was to clarify which one is following the truth, he has to give something extra. The criteria. He said, مِثْلُ مَا أَنَا عَلَيْهِ الْيَوْمَ وَأَصْحَابِي. Where I'm on today and my companions. Likewise, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the hadith of Ibn Mas'ud in Bukhari Muslim, and Imran ibn Husayn, and Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the best people in my generation, and those who come after them, and those who come after them. The three generations. And Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam is Sahih Muslim. He said to his daughter Fatima, I'm a blessed salaf to you. Ibn Abbas, may Allah please with him, Allah's statement in Surah Ali Imran, يَوْمَ تَبْيَضُ وُجُوهُ وَتَسْوَدُ وُجُوهُ, as Abu Ja'far Muhammad ibn al-Tabari mentioned in his tafsir, قَالَ Ibn Abbas, تَبْيَضُ وُجُوهُ أَهْلِ السُّنَّةِ. On the day of resurrection, some face will be the light and enlightened, and some face will be darkened. Ibn Abbas, he did not say the face that will be enlightened, the face of the Muslims. He said أَهْلِ السُّنَّةِ, to differentiate. So when the splitting happened, the people of Sunnah, Sahaba, had to give an extra name, which has been taken from the Sunnah, to distinguish ourselves from the other groups. So it's not something which is new.
Yeah,
so wa'tasimu bihablillah jami'a, the verse, where is hablillah? Hablillah to for the Salaf al-Salih. So it's not us, we're splitting. What happened? The Ummah was holding into one body. For example, this one body, yeah?
Okay.
All of them. After the king of Uthman, the Khawarij left the main body. Shia left the main body. Qadariya left the main body. Jahmiyyah, likewise. Al-Murji'ah, Al-Karramiyyah, Al-Mu'tazilah, Al-Ash'ariyyah, Dubandiyyah. There are some people still holding to the main body. What we do in our time, instead of saying to those who left the main body, why are you splitting? We are criticizing those who are still holding onto the main body by telling them why you are splitting. No, we're not splitting, alhamdulillah. We are still holding onto the Al-Amr Al-Atiq, the ancient path, which is the path of the Sahaba. You understand, akhi?
Yeah.
But I'm not saying get t-shirt, I'm Salafi, walk on the street.
Yeah, no, my general point was actually, if you make a group for yourself, like in the name of Shia, and the other people say, okay, we make also a group in the name of something else, and they say, they think right, they do the right way, and the other group say, okay, we are right, and the other say, so, my point is actually, we all made that going to the same way that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam
says. No, but we're not, in reality, we're not. Shia, they're not going the same way as us.
Yeah.
And the group, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said there will be groups. And he said, in another narration, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, illa wahida, one group. He mentioned into groups. So there was a group, and Allah said, ala inna hizballahum al-ghalibun. No hizballah of Iran, or of Lebanon, no. Hizballah, those of the Quran, the Sunnah of the Salaf al-Salih. Allah called it a group. You know, a group, it's no problem with a group. Because the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, in another narration, al-jama'ah, a group. But it's not about a group or not. Is that a group following the truth?
Right.
So there is groups now. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us about it, you know? So we cannot deny that. We cannot close our eyes. All of us, we are one. No, we are groups. So how do you know the true group? The group that is from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the criteria. What is it? So for the Salaf or Salih. So to summarize it, for example, I say, I follow Quran and the Sunnah and the Sahaba and the Tabi'een, Atba'at Tabi'een. To summarize it, what I say, I'm a Salafi. What does that mean? I follow a Salaf or Salih, who are the three generations who follow the Quran and the Sunnah the best way.
Yeah.
Alhamdulillah. Amin wa iyyak. Barakallahu fikum. So alhamdulillah, I haven't seen your video with Ali. But you know, alhamdulillah, al-kalam is waste of time, akhi. You know? And I spoke to Muhammad Hijab outside Speaker's Corner 2 weeks ago. I said, we need to use more Quran. He said, yeah, because we're not confident. That's why he said to me, we're not. Alhamdulillah, me, I use Quran alhamdulillah all the time, you know? That's my way, because why? Quran is the criteria. Giving analogies, that is the Quran and the Sunnah and the Salaf way, you understand? By using this kalam arguments and, you know, actually 2 hours, literally that video was translated in Arabic, yeah? Was translated in Arabic. If you read the comment section, majority of people had no clue what they were talking about.
Another thing I find so beautiful about Salafia is that it's always evidences as well. It's always the words of the scholars.
Like you are. Same thing happened to me, Akhi.
Yeah.
What attracted me to Salafia, I remember once I was sitting down with my friend, my brother Salah, Iranian, yeah? So he asked me, where is Allah? You know? So I said, Allah is everywhere. He said, where's the proof? I said, no! So I was in a mosque, yeah? And there was one guy with a qamis and a bed. I said, ask him. He said, no. He's not proof. Doesn't mean because someone has a qamis and a bed, he has, you understand? He's like, you need to go to gym. Anyone that is big, he knows about gym. No, he said, not like that. He said, where Allah said that? Prophet Muhammad said that. And I got angry. I'm not going to lie. Because he put me in a spot. But after speaking, it's true. So Salafiyya, Allah said, Rasul said, the Sahaba said, you know? Same thing happened to me, Akhi.
Alhamdulillah.
Thing, exactly. Quran and Sunnah, the way of the Salaf. Simple.
Proof everything with the evidence.
Akhi, you know this, what's happening with the atheists now, what's happening to Muslims? The Muslims notice the atheists.
Again, your brother came.
They're rejecting clear proofs in the Quran.
Yeah.
So instead of the Muslim being proud, say, okay, you reject it, I will threaten you with Jahannam. And if you believe they have paradise, they don't do that. Because why? We have inferiority complex. So if you know what? This person sounds smart. Let me use his method. I'm not going to use your method.
Hamza,
I'm going to use
it. Yeah, I was going to say that. I think there was a saying of Ibn Surudi. He said, Al Jama'atu wa faqal.
You understand him?
Barakallah.
That statement I find very amazing as well. Because you know, a lot of the Ash'ari, they like to make the appeal. Like As-Subki used to say, oh, most of the people are Ash'ari. But then it doesn't mean you're not the truth.
Yeah, yeah. That is, also, that is a lie. Because was that a fight or something? Yeah, these Christians, they just, you know, that's what they're looking for. That is a lie, that's not true. What happened when before the Ottoman Empire, Sa'din Ayyubi, may Allah have mercy upon him and forgive him, he had people that were surrounding him, that were Ash'ari, okay? And they had to force Ash'ariya on many, many countries, you understand? So Ash'ari was forced upon people. You know, it's not something which is naturally you're born with, you understand? But naturally you're born, Allah's above everything. Naturally you're born to make dua up, you understand? So Ash'ari, they come, you know, as Fakhruddin al-Razi and al-Ghazali, he said, if we speak about our aqidah to the awam, they will leave Islam. Yes, Fakhruddin al-Razi and al-Ghazali mentioned that. He said, the way we speak about our aqidah should not be spoken from the awam, otherwise they will leave Islam.
Ibrahim
al-Bayjuri
said that as well.
Ibrahim al-Bayjuri, subhanallah,
in
Jawhara. Subhanallah, look. So this is the calamity, akhi. The Ash'ariya kalam, because it's simple. Did Abu Bakr al-Siddiq sit and he said, Allah is above the arsh, he said in the verse. But though Allah is no jism, Allah is no ava, Allah is not this, Allah is no muhayyaz, Allah is not this, none of that. This Ash'ari way is a poison because of the kalam philosophy. You know, Allah is not this, not that. What we know Allah in detail said, أَلَا تَسْجُدُوا لِمَا خَلَقْتُ بِيَدَيْ. نعم, بِيَدَيْ, simple, what is the diet? Understand it. Another verse, you know, Qurtubi in his tafsir, likewise in his Kitab al-Asna, في شرح أسماء الله الحسنى, he said the way of the Salaf al-Salih, the diet of the Quran and the Sunnah, and the way of the Salaf al-Salih, and what is been narrated from them, from the thiqat, that Allah is above the arsh, حَقِيقَةً. Then he goes on to say, but I don't choose this qawl, I choose the other qawl. How on the earth you leave the qawl of the Salaf and you choose the other qawl? Because why? Himself, he was poisoned by Al-Kalam. Subhanallah. He mentioned that in his book that the Salaf believe and Al-Kalam believe Allah is not above, because if he's above, he's in the Makan. Not Salaf, Al-Kalam believe that. Then he mentioned Salaf said, no, Salaf believe Allah is above the Arsh haqiqatan.
Remember the woman who asked Prophet Muhammad to say,
Ayn Allah?
Yeah,
and say, it's a the Shahid, barakallah fiqh, akhi. So we looked at the way of the Salafiyya, Ahl Sunnah al-Jama'ah, simple. Allah said, Prophet Muhammad said, the Sahaba said, Tabi'in said, Atba'a Tabi'in said. That's the way of the Salaf al-Salih. We use the Quran and the Sunnah. I mean, look, even this Iman al-Muqallid. They say, the Iman al-Muqallid means you have to do your own investigation, firstly to prove Allah's existence. No, we don't have to do that, because believing Allah's existence, we are born with it. Naturally, we're born to believe there is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, every human being, not just the Muslims, we're not saying he believes that God is named Allah, but believe there is a creator and he should be worshipped alone. You know, but now what's happening, akhi? Because ilm al-kalam and in Western academia is based upon philosophy. What is philosophy? Pure skepticism. Doubting everything. And I'm not negating the certain things you use skepticism, but are you going to doubt I'm speaking to you right now? Except you're Majnun. Last week I was speaking to this guy. I said to him, am I speaking to you? He said, there's probability I'm not. I said, do you have a phone? He said, yes. I said, give it to me. He gave me the phone. I said, there's probability you never had the phone, correct? Bye-bye. You know, he said, no, give me the phone. You see, when you put them in the real test, they change. So what's happened, Akhi, may Allah bless you, and my brothers out there, there are some people out there, they're arrogant to worship Allah. They don't want to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, according to Prophet Muhammad, because they're too arrogant. Me, I study in Oxford University, I have qualification. I'm going to follow this man. Or they want to do haram, and the only way to do it by rejecting Allah. But they're not going to say that. So what they're going to do, they're going to start looking for any silly argument. And what they do, they beautify it with a good, nice slogans to confuse the awam. But it boils down to, he's arrogant, he doesn't worship Allah. Simple. And we are entertaining that. Instead of him, stop using this nonsensical argument. Deep down, you know you're a liar. Don't want to tell you like that. So deep down, you know this is not true. There's a creator, this tremendous creation. Stop using argument and submit to him. Otherwise, in the hellfire, no doubt about that. You accept it? Bye bye. You know? 2 hours was, may Allah bless you. 2 hours just talking about atom, this, that, this, and the guy you bring him one argument, he bring another argument, and it caused more confusion.
I think Muhammad Hijab, like, he used argument that Ibn Taymiyyah, like, used to allow, basically using logic, and he's saying for that reason we should use Kalam, basically. Like, what's the response to that?
The response to the Akhi, imagine Ibn Taymiyyah, the statement he used for Ibn Taymiyyah, where you got it from? You got it from a book refuting logic. So how, not only logic, because logic, we're talking about sound reasoning, no problem with that. We use the term logic, but sound reasoning, it goes in line with the Quran, our sound reasoning. But the logic that Ibn Taymiyyah said, for example, he said some people will be hard to accept the truth except by going in depth. How you do it? Not the way that Muhammad Hijab is doing it, no. How you do it, for example, there's 2 ways to refute Darwinian evolution. Either by general way or going in detail. There's no harm with that. But if I know I'm going to refute Darwinian evolution with a method, go against my own belief, am I going to use that? No. So Ibn Taymiyyah is not speaking about that. So are you telling me Ibn Taymiyyah is going to tell you, go use an argument? For example, they say the proof that this universe is dependent because it has a limit. Yeah? Person can say to him, okay, your God is inside the creation or outside the creation? It's at the creation. So that's what the ulama of the seven said, Lillahi hadd. Allah has limits in a way. No one knows Allah's limit except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What they meant by that? Allah is separate from his creation, his essence. So okay, so now what are you gonna do? You're gonna start doubting your belief. You see how this dangerous argument, that's why Abkhadin al-Razi start doubting.
Are you
that's
gonna
why,
talk to the brother?
Yeah, I will, but I'm speaking to him.
Go ahead, finish up so we can finish.
You understand, Akhi? So that's
lying.
Why last week.
You there's Muslim.
No.
You say you don't know.
Anyway, he's going to come speak to us. I will welcome you to speak to you. My point here is, Akhi, so Ibn Taymiyyah is speaking about a specific thing. Yes, you go in detail, refute them, show them the contradictions and so on. But not use their method, which go against the Quran. Yeah. You understand? Barakallahu fi. So even, also, we don't blindfold Ibn Taymiyyah. Ibn Taymiyyah is not our messenger, you know? So you know the problem with these people, when we say, no, Ibn Taymiyyah was wrong here, they said, ah, you don't follow Ibn Taymiyyah. If we do follow him, they say, you're blind, follow him. If we say, no, we don't accept that statement, why don't I follow him? So make up your mind, are we blind follow Ibn Taymiyyah or not? But what the people of these ayahs do, instead of reading the whole works of Ibn Taymiyyah, understand his kalam, they get caught here, caught there. Like the Dubandis, he can choose. Like this Dubandis up north. What they do, he has not read Aqid al-Wasliya by Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen. He pick up one statement of Ibn Uthaymeen, isolated from his context, and he said Ibn Uthaymeen said that. That's not how you study. Sikh ilm. Barakallahu fiqh.